Here's how to use Siri Pro mode. Hey Siri Pro. Show me a recipe for pancakes. Siri Pro mode will then speak and display the result. To use Siri Pro, you'll need to learn how to enable Siri Pro by using a shortcut to turn Siri into ChatGPT. It's easy to do, so just follow along with the steps. To get Siri Pro mode or Siri ChatGPT on iPhone or iOS, the first step is to create a ChatGPT account. If you haven't already, you can do it for free in just 2 minutes. So go to this website or follow along with the tutorial video above. It's a very standard sign-up process. Once you have a ChatGPT account, the next step is to create a custom Siri shortcut in the iPhone Shortcuts app. Now, I've watched a couple other Siri Pro YouTube videos on this, but their method just didn't work for me. So don't worry, I've done all the hard work for you to make this work 100%. So make sure you watch the video right to the end, and I'll show you how to download the Siri ChatGPT shortcut straight to your iPhone or iOS device. So here now is the Siri Pro ChatGPT shortcut. I can enable it with Hey Siri Pro.
Yes.
I can test it by tapping it inside the Shortcuts app, or I can test it by tapping the shortcut settings and pressing the play button down the bottom. Okay, once you've downloaded the Siri Pro mode shortcut, you have to do something very important. So step three is to generate your own API, which links this shortcut with your ChatGPT account. So you can see when you open up the shortcut settings, there's a field here saying generate and add your API key here. So in the example before, I'd already had my API key pasted in here, but when you download this shortcut, this field won't have the API and instead it'll have this field in here. And in fact, if you try and run it as it is, it will go ahead and ask you to add in your API key and the Siri Pro shortcut won't work. It's easy to add in your API, so you'll need to go to this website, peter.openai.com/account/api-keys, and you'll need to log in to your ChatGPT account, or if that's not working for you, just sign up. So I'll skip ahead and do the login process because I've shown this in previous videos. So it'll start off by saying that you have no secret API key like this, but I've already created an API and the system recognizes that. So it's displaying my existing key here. So what you'd need to do is tap create new secret key and then copy the API key. So head back over to your shortcut and paste in your key, which I'll blur out for now, and tap done. Now you can go ahead and test it by either saying the command or just tap it here to test it out. Tell me a joke. So the shortcut is asking if it can access your API. So I'll click allow.
Q, what did the fish say when he hit the wall? A, damn.
Okay, classic dad joke that one, but you can see that it's working. Let's now try that with the voice command. Hey Siri Pro.
Yes?
Tell me a pancake recipe.
Ingredients. 1.5 cups all-purpose flour. 3.5 teaspoons.
So you can see it will display and speak through the instructions for that. Let's now compare it to the regular Siri. Hey Siri, tell me the recipe for pancakes. So you can see that Siri's not going to actually read through each of these recipes. I'd actually have to go through and browse which one I think would be good and then open that up. So it's a lot slower with the regular Siri. Siri Pro is much faster and direct. In a moment, I'll show you how to access and download this Siri Pro shortcut. But first, here's a quick story on a helpful use case of ChatGPT. Previously, I had absolutely no experience on how to write any type of code, nor any basic code even in the Shortcuts app. So I actually asked ChatGPT to show me how to create this shortcut app. ChatGPT then detailed 7 steps to do so. So I went ahead and followed its directions. Some errors did come up from time to time with a couple of the steps. So I just asked ChatGPT for more detail on those steps. That detail was then provided and eventually I was able to get the shortcut to work. So if you need help in any technical area, just ask ChatGPT. It was a pretty cool feeling to work together to create this shortcut. Now, the only time this shortcut won't work is if the ChatGPT server is full, which does happen from time to time. So you might get Siri Pro saying, something went wrong, or just an okay, or that's done. In that case, you might need to give Siri Pro a rest for a while. But don't worry, the ChatGPT app will still work. And you can watch this video above to learn how to download this ChatGPT app shortcut on your phone. So to download and enable Siri Pro Mode shortcut, just go in the description or in the pinned comment below and tap on the link. Here's some information about the shortcut. You tap that to open it to check it out. You say this to make it run, and then I can just tap add shortcut. Now I've already got one called Siri Pro, so I can either replace it or keep both. I'll just keep both in this situation, just so I can show you how it appears into the Shortcuts app. So here it is, and I can see if I open that up, it's asking me for that prompt to generate and add your API key. Again, if I tap it, it's gonna ask for my API key. So there you go. Finally, if you like, you can tap here and then rename what you need to say to activate Siri Pro. So you might just say, help me, or maybe use Chat GPT. Whatever you like. Now that you've got ChatGPT as Siri Pro mode, watch this video next to learn how to download a ChatGPT iPhone app shortcut for those times when you don't want to ask Siri Pro, but you still want to have ChatGPT at your fingertips. So click that now and I'll see you there.